students for grade 11 and 10 physical education, St. Peter's College, Kalamafu, Nigambo branch. Today, I'm going to discuss with you about the athletic events. Under athletic events, we will discuss about the triple jump, the rules and regulations for triple jump, and the javelin throw, and the rules and regulations for javelin throw. Fine. Let us learn about jumping and throwing events in athletics. This is lesson number 12 under grade 11, health and physical education. Under jumping events, we will look into the classification of the jumping events, horizontal jumping and the vertical jumping. Under horizontal jumping, long jump and the triple jump. Under vertical jumps, we can put high jump and the pole vault. Next, the throwing events. Under throwing events, short part, discus throw, javelin throw, and hammer throw. These are the activities that we can carry out under throwing events. Now we will discuss the triple jump. Under triple jump, we will discuss about the main bases of triple jump and the rules and regulations as well as the play area of triple jump. The triple jump, there are some requirements for the triple jump event. You need more energy, force, and the tremendous momentum. Force and the momentum, they are the principles of biomechanics. These are the requirements for the triple jump. There are phases of triple jump. There are five phases: approach jump, hop, step, jump, and landing. Altogether, there are five steps in triple jump. Here you can look at this diagram. Application of the phases in triple jump: approach jump, the athlete take off. Hop, step, jump. Under triple jump, we consider these three are the main three steps, but as a whole, there are five steps. And the final one, the landing. Then, the correct method of takeoff. When we apply the takeoff method, here we use the right foot, first takeoff, second takeoff, same foot, third takeoff, so you change the foot to left, and finally the jumping is done with both feet. Here the takeoff is done with the right leg. Right, right, left, you change your leg, and finally landing from or jumping from both feet. Application of the phases in triple jump. When the takeoff is done with the right leg. Here the takeoff is done with the right foot. This is the first takeoff. Second takeoff with the same foot. So we cover this step as the hop. Then you move to the third takeoff. And also you change your foot to left. It is the step and jumping with both feet. Now we will take one by one the main phases. First, the approach run. The distance for the approach run varies from athlete to athlete. For beginners, it's about 10 steps. For experts, 17 to 20, and for trained athletes, it's about 17 to 20 steps. Body should be kept relaxed and straight. Relaxed and straight body. Running should be done raising the knees upward. The athlete has to raise the knees upward when running. Hop. It is the first jump. Foot on the takeoff board. Keep the foot on the takeoff board. Exerting more pressure on the takeoff board. The takeoff leg should be extended forward. The takeoff leg, you can refer the diagrams here. The takeoff leg should be extended forward. Maintenance of the body balance. The two arms should swung backward. Here you can see the arms should swung backwards. And at this position, the takeoff leg is completely straightened. Takeoff leg is completely straightened. These are the steps or the methods to be followed under hop or the first jump. A second one is the second takeoff is a step. Takeoff is made with the same foot, right. Then hand should be swung well. The left leg of the athlete is further raised. This is the left leg. The left leg should be raised further. Left foot is lowered and the landing is done with the left foot. Lowering the left foot and landing to the ground. These are the steps for the second takeoff. Next one, for the jumping, body of the athlete should be raised. The thigh of the right leg parallel to the ground. Flight phase or the flight mode or the hanging technique is applied here. End of the flight phase, body is prepared for landing. Now, this is the flight phase and now the body is ready for landing. When you get ready for the landing step, you have to lean the body. The upper body is leaned forward. You can see the diagram, the body is leaned forward. The two legs are straightened and extended forward. The two hands are extended forward. Extending the legs forward as well as the hands. Next, the landing. Straightening the legs from the knee bend when foot touches the ground. Straightening the legs from the knee bend when foot touches the ground. The athlete moves forward in the sitting posture. From this posture, moving to the sitting posture. The hands should be rotated forward very fast. Rotation of the hands when we come to the sitting posture, when the athlete comes to the sitting posture, the rotation of the hands should be very fast. Then this is the play area for the triple jump. You can see here the length of this the area given for the approach run after the takeoff board is 40 meters. From takeoff board for the to the margin of the landing area, the first margin is about 11 to 13 meters. This is the whole length, about 51 or 54 meters. That is the whole length for this part. And this is the landing area. And here the width of the landing area is given there. This is the landing or the play area of the triple jump. Next, there are some, we can do different activities to improve the skills for the triple jump. Here there are some activities that we can do to improve the skills of the triple jump. Keep some obstacles and cross over them. Then mark some areas on the ground and move about that area by jumping forward. That is to develop the stepping, hopping skills. Practice the three phases, jump, hop, step. You can practice all these things with help of these activities. Then we see the rules and regulations of triple jump. Apply three phases, hop, step and jump consecutively. You can do these three steps. This is a must. hop, step and jump consecutively. Then at the hop phase, the landing should be made with the same foot that was used for the takeoff. You can refer the diagram. First takeoff, right. Second takeoff, right. Third takeoff, you change the leg to left and jumping with both feet. At the step phase, landing should be made with the opposite foot and the same foot should be used for the takeoff for the jump according to the diagram. If free leg touches the ground during jump, it is not considered as a foul. It is not a foul. Now we will move to the javelin throw. Under javelin throw, there are several techniques, or we call seven phases are there. Preparation, approach time, pulling the javelin backward, crossover, power positioning, delivery, and finally recovery or follow through. These are the seven techniques of javelin. Now, we'll take one by one. First, preparation. Thrower should stand facing the direction in which the javelin is to be thrown. Suppose I am throwing the javelin to this direction, front. So, the player should, or the particular athlete should put his face to the direction of the grounds or to the place where he throw the javelin. Then the javelin should be held over the shoulders just above the ear, just above the ear, over the shoulders just above the ear. Javelin remains parallel to the grounds. You can see the javelin is parallel to the grounds. The elbow of the hand is in which the javelin is held should be directed towards the front in this manner. Elbow should be directed towards the front. These are the steps to be followed under preparation. Then second one, approach run. The throwers run rhythmically to gain initial momentum. The momentum is a principle of biomechanics. Javelin throwers may run about 30 to 19 steps. Beginners may run about 6 to 12 steps. These are the rules for the approach run. Then the third one, pulling the javelin backward. With the first of the last 5 steps of the approach run, the thrower begins to pull the hand in which the javelin is held backward behind the shoulders. Backwards behind the shoulders. At the third of the last 5 steps, the javelin is completely pulled back. You can refer these diagrams. Third and fourth, the javelin that is pulled backwards is held inclined with an angle with the head. Inclined with the head. Not parallel to the ground, inclined. Have to angle the javelin. The fourth one, crossover. The crossover is done at the penultimate steps, that means the last 4 steps. The hand in which the javelin is held is straightened. The foot corresponding to the land, corresponding to the hand in which the javelin is held, is moved forwards with a long stride after the crossover. The left foot is moved forward once again. The left foot is moved forward once again. Is the left. These are the steps to be followed under crossover. Under power positioning, gathering power, when the fourth step ends, the power positioning starting. At the power position, the body is leaned a little backward. Bending the body backward, the javelin is held in the right hand. This is the right leg, this is the right hand. The athlete is holding the javelin in his right hand. And the left leg is straightened. This is the straight left leg. Well towards the front. Straightening the left leg. Well towards the front. Holding the javelin with the right hand. Sixth one is the delivery. The javelin is launched from over the head. Not below the head. Over the head. The hip is turned forward vigorously. Quick turning of the hip. The front foot is straightened at the knee. Javelin is launched by pulling forward, upwards, the elbow of the hand with the javelin. Forward and upward. When the javelin is released, the back of the thrower is bent. Bending the back of the thrower when the javelin is released. Right, these are the steps to be followed under delivery. Then the last one, the recovery or the follow through. Throw the javelin, put the right foot and control the thrower speed. The purpose of put the right foot front to control the speed of the thrower. The upper body is bent forward. Bending the upper body forward, body balance should be maintained here. Next one, here you can see the application of all the seven paces. Preparation, approach run, pulling the javelin backward, crossover, hover positioning, delivery, recovery or the follow through. All these steps are applied in this diagram. This is the play area of javelin. The runway of the javelin play area about 36 meters, and the angle between the sector lines is 29 degrees. This is the play area of javelin. How to develop the skills of javelin? Throw a light ball to a distance overhead. You can practice this several times to improve the throwing skills. Put the javelin backward over the head. Throw it hard onto the ground so that the point of the javelin hits the ground. Throw the javelin according to the power positioning methods. You can do these activities to improve the skills of javelin. Now we will see the age-wise weight of the javelin. Here the age limits and the gender. Under 16, boys 600 grams, for girls 500 grams. Under 18, boys 700 grams, for girls 500 grams. Under 20, boys 800 grams and for girls 600 grams. These are the age-wise weights of javelin. Now we will look into the rules and regulations for javelin. Hold the javelin from the grip with single hand. This is the grip, holding the javelin from the grip with the single hand. The javelin should be thrown over the shoulder and above the forearm. This is the standard method. You can refer the diagram here. Throwing the javelin over the shoulders and above the forearm. This is the standard method of throwing the javelin. Rules and regulations for javelin. There are some more. The metal point of the javelin should hit the ground. Once the competition is commenced, no permission to enter to the play area for any practices. The javelin should land inside the angle of the landing area, not in the side of the these sectors, inside the angle. The thrower should remain within the limits of the throwing area until the javelin has launched. You can't move. Once you throw it, you can't move from the play area. The thrower should start making his attempts within 1 minute after the number of thrower has been announced. Another rule. Before releasing the javelin, the athlete should not make a complete turn of the body. Before releasing it, the athlete cannot make a complete turn of the body. Throwers back faces the throwing area. Throwers back should face to the throwing area. Fine. Thank you very much for the participation. Have a blessed day.